You're listening to the audio production of The Wonder of Creation, 100 More Devotions About God and Science by Louie Giglio with Tama Fortner. Published by Thomas Nelson and read by Louie Giglio, James Vore, and Tori Vore. Please note that you may download an accompanying PDF that provides enhanced materials for this audiobook. To download the PDF, please visit harperchristianaudio.com.
Introduction. Hello, Explorer. My name is Pastor Louie. I've been fascinated by science and space since I was your age, and I am amazed by God and all of His creation. Whether you've already read one of my other two books about science and faith, Indescribable or How Great Is Our God, or you're new to the Indescribable Kids family, welcome. I can't wait to jump into this new adventure and explore the wonder of creation together. I'm a curious person, and I bet you are too. For example, have you ever wondered why cats have whiskers? Or maybe you've asked why our cheeks get all warm and red when we get embarrassed. Or perhaps you've asked what it's called when a big tornado mixes with a blazing wildfire. Spoiler alert, it's a fire-nado. For all the questions you wonder about, there is someone who knows every answer. God. He made everything on this planet and in all the galaxies. And here's the most amazing part. He invites us to ask all our questions and to uncover the wonder of creation. This audiobook is filled with 100 mind-blowing and fun-filled devotions about the beauty God intentionally created throughout the universe. We could write a zillion devotions about God, and it wouldn't even scratch the surface of how wonderful He truly is. As much as we continue to discover about space, earth, animals, and people, there are still endless treasures to find. From rushing waterfalls to crashing waves, and from mountain peaks to the green grasses of the prairies, everything God made is overflowing with wonder and shows us how great He is. Throughout this audiobook, we'll focus our minds and hearts on learning about what God has made by reading about different parts of His creation, digging into amazing science facts, talking with Him in prayer, and growing deeper in knowledge to understand His brilliance. My hope for you is that as you dive into these pages, you would see the inspiring connection between the world around you and the God who created it. I'm so glad that you've joined me for this exploration. As we get ready to take off, prepare to have your minds blown and your eyes opened to this truth. God has woven amazing wonder into all of creation. So let's begin discovering it. Enjoy the adventure ahead. Hi, everyone. It's Pastor Louie. And before we get officially into the start of the wonder of creation, I just want to say welcome to the journey and welcome to the adventure. This is our third resource in the Indescribable Kids devotional series, and I am pumped. I think it could be the best one yet. Our team is phenomenal and amazing, and I know that you are really going to have a great time discovering not only what God has made, but discovering who He is. If you're one of the incredible, indescribable kids that are on the journey with us, I just want to say I'm so glad you're here. I want to remind you that no question is too big for God. So be curious and ask whatever question is in your heart, because no matter what we wonder about creation, the beauty is we know the God who made all of creation. And He's going to lead us on this journey. And at the end of the day, He's going to lead us to know more in more about him. At the center of all creation, we're going to find Jesus, and he's the one who's holding all creation together and holding you together and holding me together as well. I want to say a special welcome to all the parents, and by parents, I mean all the adults who might be listening in this moment. I just want to encourage you. There are a lot of free resources that you can find at indescribablekids.com, but I also want to encourage you that you're really going to get a ton out of the wonder of creation. It's been so fun over the past few years watching kids as they've interacted with these devotions, but then watching their older brothers and sisters kind of sneak in the kitchen afterwards and crack the book open for themselves, and hearing the parents say, I am learning a lot in my faith, and I feel like I'm growing in my confidence in God as well. So thank you for making this resource available for these incredible, indescribable kids. But get ready. You're going to learn a lot of cool things, and I believe you're going to find yourself being encouraged in your faith as well. I want to say thank you to James and Tori Vore. They're going to be reading all of the 100 devotions in this book. They are amazing and have done so much to help us get our Indescribable Kids podcast off the ground. And then I just want to pray for us, because I know that this book has the potential to plant seeds that in time are going to change our lives. And so, Lord, thank you for the incredible privilege of knowing you. Just to think, as we look and see the world around us, the stars and the sky at night and the mountain peaks, the big ocean waves crashing on the shore, the smallest and the tiniest of creatures crawling across the earth, and the most ferocious lion that is in the jungle. And to think that everything we see in creation, that not only do we get to enjoy the beauty of it all, the wonder of it all, but that we have the possibility of actually knowing you, the creator of everything. God, thank you that not only have you made the world around us, but you made us, the reason that we can hear right now, see the beauty on these pages, use our mouths to read the words, have a brain in our head to understand the ideas, can be moved and touched in our heart to have our fears calmed and to be more courageous with you. That's because you made us amazingly beautiful, unique, with incredible potential. So Lord, will you come and meet us in these pages? Will you inspire us and make us laugh? Will you teach us and make us strong? But more than anything, will you make us confident that the same God who made the world made us, and the one who holds it all together, he leads and guides our lives every day. So to every boy, to every girl, to every mom, to every dad, every teacher, every leader, every grandmother, every grandfather, every brother, sister who's listening along, even though they're not really the age range for the book, to every single ear and heart, will you speak in a beautiful and personal way and show us who Jesus is? That's our prayer. In his name, amen. I hope you enjoy the wonder of creation.
Devotion number one, get a little closer. Jesus opened their minds so they could understand the scriptures. Luke 24:45. Some scientists say we know more about the surface of Mars than about the bottom of the oceans. But the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Association, NOAA for short, is working to change that. In 2009, NOAA launched the Okeanos Explorer ship to map and explore the ocean floor. A remote control vehicle called Deep Discoverer dives down to 19,000 feet underwater. That's over 3.5 miles down. Along the way, it takes pictures, collects samples, and discovers creatures like the Duobrachium sparxae, a new species of comb jelly, and a ghost-like octopod that no one has ever seen before. Each year, Okeanos maps between 23,000 and 38,000 square miles. But since the ocean is over 139 million square miles, I think we've still got a lot of ground, water, to cover. Space satellites can give us a rough outline of what's down there, but to fill in all the details, explorers need to dive in and get a little closer. That's true about God, too. If we just look at him during church once a week, We can learn something about who he is, and that's great. But to fill in the details, we need to dive into his word and get a little closer. That means looking up words we don't know, asking for help with verses we don't understand, and talking to God about what it all means. When you set out to discover more about God, you'll meet the one who's more amazing than anything you could discover here on earth, even at the bottom of the ocean. God, I want to deeply know you. Help me fill in the details and understand what I read in your word. Amen. Let's explore the wonder. Are there lilies under the sea? Sort of. These flowers bloomed years and years ago when volcanic activity in the Gulf of Mexico forced streams of thick tar up through the cracks in the ocean floor. Kind of like squeezing Play-Doh through your fingers. As the tar cooled in the water, it took the shape of huge flower petals, so scientists called them tar lilies.
Devotion 2. A plan and a purpose. The Lord will work out his plans for my life. Psalm 138:8. This might sound gross, but did you know that there's this little worm-like pouch inside your body? It's about 2 to 4 inches long, and scientists had no idea why it's there until recently. That little pouch is called the appendix. It's attached to your large intestine, which is attached to your small intestine, which is 22 feet long and not all that small, which is attached to your stomach. Whew! Those organs all work together to digest your food, except the appendix. For years, scientists believed the appendix had no real purpose. But now, they believe it's actually pretty important. It stores good bacteria, not the bad kind that makes you sick, which is important because your digestive system needs good bacteria to break down your food. But when you get sick, especially with a stomach ache, the good bacteria can get flushed out of your system. That's when the appendix comes to the rescue. It releases the stored up good bacteria and gets your digestive system back on track. Okay, let's think about this. If God has an important purpose for even that tiny, worm-like pouch in your belly, just imagine what he's got planned for your whole body. God created you and put you in this time and place for a reason. And he's going to use everything that happens in your life, yes, even the things that don't seem to have a purpose right now, to help you grow and learn and be able to carry out his plan for you. Some days, it might be hard to see, but never doubt that God's got a plan and a purpose created just for you. Lord, I know you have good plans for me, plans that will show off just how awesome you are. Please direct me in the next step to take. Amen. Let's explore the wonder. Ever wonder how food gets through your digestive system? Muscle power. Waves of muscle movement, kind of like the waves in the ocean, push food down your esophagus into the stomach and then through the intestines. It's called peristalsis. Since it uses muscle power instead of gravity, you could digest your food standing on your head.
Devotion number 3. Lost and found. God is being patient with you. He does not want anyone to be lost. He wants everyone to change his heart and life. 2 Peter 3:9. No one has seen a Somali Senji since 1973. What's a Somali Senji, you ask? It's a species of elephant shrew. Yeah, it's mouse-sized, but it really is related to the elephant. Just check out its extra long nose. For almost 50 years, scientists believed the Somali Senji was extinct, but they kept hearing rumors about Senjis being spotted in the rocky lands of Djibouti in Africa. So in 2019, scientists set out over 1,200 traps to find them. For bait, they used a mixture of peanut butter, oatmeal, and yeast. Turns out, Senjis love peanut butter. Scientists caught and safely released 12 Somali Senjis. The animal everyone thought was lost had been found. Scientists didn't want the Somali Senji to be lost, and God doesn't want you or anyone else to be lost either. This isn't lost like being lost in a city. This lost means a person hasn't trusted God to be the Lord of their life. That's why God never stops searching for us and chasing after us with his love. Sometimes it's in big ways, like sending Jesus to save us from sin. And other times, it's in smaller ways, like sending a friend to remind us how much God loves us. God never gives up on anyone. Not the nosy neighbor, the pizza delivery guy, or that mean kid on the bus.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.